Hey there, ladies and gentlemen of Frag Nation, Daily here. And today we have the free-to-play spotlight. We are checking out Soldier Front 2. This is a free-to-play game that you can get on the Ariel or Areola or wherever the hell you say that, the name of that thing's workshop. You can also grab it off of Steam on the free-to-play section. So the first thing I want to talk about is the tire layout here. We really see this a lot. This looks really similar to Combat Arms or any game that kind of, models that Ava or whatever that other one that's going around, Arctic Combat. They all kind of look the same to me in the menu system. But this one stands out in a few different places. The graphics, for one, they look pretty good. You see a detailed character model here. Not really particularly my style of graphic, but definitely good for a free-to-play game. You see everything's rendered nice. You got some lighting textures there. Moving on into the armory, this is where the game's got some good stuff going for it. These are your base weapons here, these two. I bought this one shortly after playing the game, so you do get this cash here pretty quickly, and you're able to buy guns and things that wear over time. And you see I have a repair button here, and I can repair guns as I use them. That's a pretty cool feature. I like that. And you can also set up different classes here. So you'll see that I'm able to set up my different classes here and here and whatnot. So in any case, once you use a weapon, it's in that class, so you don't have unlimited weapons, which was, I thought was pretty cool. So if you put the pistol on this class, and it's there, and so on and so forth. So you have to buy this pistol again if you want to put it into another class, which kind of redefines that word armory, not unlimited guns and ammo for you. So moving on, you have gear. You can customize depending on what operator you are. I chose Delta Force, so I could get gear that way. I've got a starter pack. Inside the starter pack comes some trial guns, so I can check these out for 7 days, as well as an experience boost. That's always nice to get starting out. So this is also a little different, and it has a few different game modes. So if you go here and you go into a channel, as you see, there's a few different channels you can go into. We can click quick start, and we have the different game modes available for this game. And you see we have team deathmatch, that's obvious, sabotage, it's like a bomb objective, party games similar to Counter-Strike, where you can play party games with your friends. You have the Xanthrid mode, which is like an alien attacks. You have the Heroes mode, which is like more melee focused, regular deathmatch, Caesar, capture territories, and escape. So you got a bunch of different game modes to choose from. There are quite a few levels in the game as well. We'll go ahead and run through those in just a few minutes. But we'll head over to the training section, and you can see where you can play the gun range, you can practice the maps, so on and so forth. Then you have your info, keeps track of your kills, death. You see I just started playing the game. I've already got a good, well not good, but I have a higher KD ratio. Shows your headshot rate, your victory rate, your rankings, all that kind of stuff. So a lot of good info here. You also can join a clan, and they have nice little clan icons, tags, things like that. Looks really nice. So they did put some work into here. There's events going on for the game. Got your friends list. This is something I want to talk about just briefly, is the screenshot archive. Basically, this game will allow you to take screenshots in video within itself, so you don't need Fraps or a recording tool to kind of do what I'm doing here. I'm going to use Fraps anyways, just so it'll be a higher quality. But you guys that don't have this kind of equipment can come in game, click the record, and it'll record the game for you. You can make your montages or whatever you nerds like to do in your spare time. So now that I have these guns here, we'll switch one out. We'll go with let's go with the Galil. I like the Galil, and then we'll hop into a training. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so we are going to hop in here to this quick training, just to kind of show you guys the controls on the left side there, to kind of practice. You can also see the graphics here. Nice rendered iron sights, not too bad. Most of the guns look pretty good like this. I haven't had a chance to really check out the attachments and things like that, so that's something you'll have to check out on your own. But I'll show you how the guns fire, show you some of the movement, I'll die a few times, and then we'll pop in and have a little bit of multiplayer footage at the very end of the video. So let's go ahead and look through this. One of the things I do like to mention is the game feels very fluid for a free-to-play game. A lot of those games I feel kind of clunky or messed up or whatever, the case may be. But this one doesn't really feel that way, so I'll go ahead and spawn us some targets. So, you got some animations here. You can see you have this guy here, nicely detailed. Well, there are a few of them inside of each other, training dummies here, but they're nicely detailed, and the movement for them looks very well. They go into ragdoll once they're dead, so they have a slight animation and then ragdoll. So, pretty cool there. In any case, you have some bomb objectives around here you can do, but we're not going to do these. I just wanted to kind of show you guys how this thing flowed when we do the multiplayer. It will not be on a it will not be commentary. It'll just be multiplayer for you. So, moving on, we're going to go back to the shop, look over a few of the other items you can buy, and then we'll be right back. Alright guys, so heading into the shop, you can buy all sorts of weapons, primary weapons here. You got different types of AKs, there's a 417 there, a FAMAS, SCAR that I've already unlocked. You got some sniper rifles, some of these have to acquire by rank, others that are unlocked and you can buy with this SP. So, sniper rifles there, submachine guns, basic ones here, UMP, you got your Vector, MP7, MP5, P90, nothing really new in the submachine gun category. Moving on, you got some machine guns, some shotguns, not very many. I would assume they're going to be adding more over time. Got quite a few secondary weapons and some good ones, I might say. You got the Glock 17, the SIG 226, the M9. And a CZ-75. I would have liked to maybe see a 1911 or something like that, but these are actually pretty good handguns. I like those. Your specials, you got some throwing knives and an awesome stabbing knife. You got a crossbow making its magnificent return. Here's some throwing things. You got some frag grenades, flashbangs, smoke grenades, just your kind of your basic stuff. Moving on to the gear, you can outfit each one of your troops differently. You got GIGN, SAS if you're a dumb British guy. We picked the Delta Force, and the Delta Force gear has got some pretty cool stuff, and you can see it kind of take effect once you click on it. You got different types of hats, you got the face gear there, gloves, face mask, boots. I believe most of these you can buy with the SP. Some of them you may have to buy with AP, which is the game's like purchasable points. But you have upper body here, like the gloves and stuff. You got the lower body, which is the boots, the accessories that we talked about. You got a watch, gas mask, all that kind of cool stuff. Face, there's a lot of cool face gear. I like this. In the items, you have different things that can reset your stats, add magazines to your slots, you can get double XP, better weapon damage, you know, just cool stuff. And then you have the aliens stuff here, the Xanthrid. When you're playing them, you can get HP boost, faster respawn, so on and so forth. So there's a lot of cool gear and items for you to buy. So with that said, this is Soldier Front. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Enjoy the few minutes of multiplayer gameplay I'm going to give you here at the end of this. And we will see you guys back on Friday for our regular review status that we will be checking out. I don't know. We're going to leave that to a surprise. So make sure to like, comment, subscribe. If you have any feedback for me, leave it positive or negative. As long as you're nice about it, I'll be nice about it. So with that said, see you guys Friday.